Today we're going to continue with our Oxford Reading Tree story, The Quest.
The 7 and 8-year-olds in Mrs. Lopez Year 3 class at Enebral are rereading the storybook The Quest.
The Quest is...
This is a storybook from Stage 9, the highest stage in the Biff, Chip and Kipper storybooks. By this stage, the children are proficient readers and writers and are now able to focus their attention on comprehension and creative writing skills.
Our main character. And who are our other characters in the story?
We will see the children looking at adjectives and dialogue words, all of which will help them with their own writing.
Yes, he stole. Have you listened there, the boys and girls, that Alex remembered to say stole. She remembered to say the verb in the past tense, because this is a story from long ago, isn't it?
Yes.
So we have to remember to try and answer with our verbs in past tense. Now, what we're going to do today, we're going to have our own quest. We're going to have our own quest, and there's lots of things we have to do with our quest this afternoon. So let's pass our books round. Remember, this afternoon, this activity, we're going to be doing in pairs, aren't we? You're each going to have your partner. Have we all got page 2 and 3 open?
Yes.
Now, you're all going to have a moment to read pages 2 and 3. You're all going to have a moment, because then to start off the quest, I'm going to be asking you on your whiteboards to start writing down some of our spelling words and some of our important words that were missing that we have in this text here. And let's start writing down on our whiteboards the list of vocabulary. Remember, you're doing this with your partners. Let's see how we've all done. Wow. Well done. Oh, some of you have even really, on your whiteboards, you've tried to try your best there with beautiful handwriting. And some of you have not just remembered the commas in the list, you've remembered after the last word, you've even remembered a full stop. Let's put our hands down. Right, let's start with this text then. Alberta, would you like to start off with the first word, please?
Long.
Long. Long ago. And José David, would you like to, please? Far away. Long ago and far away, there was a beautiful...
Land.
Land, that's right. There was a beautiful land. We're coming now to the last few words in our text, boys and girls. What's the word that we had there, Lydia?
Told.
Told. Let's continue reading. Every animal, every plant, and every... Davinia, would you like to give us
Tree.
The last word? Tree. Thank you. Right. So all of you now are going to turn to pages 6 and 7. We're going to be finding adjectives. And what are our adjective words?
Describing words.
Yes, there are describing words that are going to be so important and so useful to you when we start doing our own story plot on our own story quests. So with your partners now, let's start finding the adjectives on those two pages. Well done, you've been working well there in your pairs, finding your adjective words. So let's hold up our whiteboards again, please, and let's see how many adjectives we've managed to find. Let's put them down, and you can be telling me now some of those adjectives you found. Right, Adriana, if you'd like to start off and tell us the first adjective you found from the page.
Dark.
Dark, well done, dark. Sergio, would you like to tell us the next adjective, please?
Grey.
Grey. Grey. I'm remembering to put my commas as well, aren't I? Raoul, would you like to please tell us one of the adjectives you found in the text?
Cold.
Cold. Wow. These are going to be interesting adjective words to help us with our plots, aren't they? Sarah, would you like to give us another adjective you found, please?
Sad.
Sad. Right. Have we all got pages 14 and 15? Because it's the last part of our quest now. We're going to look for dialogue words to replace said. Because they are going to be so useful when we start writing our own story quest. So let's see if we can find on those pages any dialogue words to replace said instead of said. Start now. Right, boys and girls. Maybe some of you would like to try now and give me some more dialogue words to help us. Nestor, would you like to give us another dialogue word, please, Nestor?
Laughed.
Our main activity, boys and girls, you have on your table two worksheets in two parts. This is a bigger version of your worksheet. And you're going to be planning your own story of a quest. Let's refresh our memories. The beginning of the story in Wilma's quest. Let's see who I'm going to choose. Who can remember what was the beginning of the story in Wilma's quest?
Long ago and far away.
Let's see if you've remembered correctly. Yes, you have. Long ago and far away, there was a beautiful land called Ulm. Who can come up with some other ideas of long ago or far away? Alberto, you've got your hand up there. What idea do you have?
Once upon a time.
Once upon a time. We've come now to our last box. What has magic power? What has the magic power, Adriana?
A ring.
A ring, that's right. Let's see if Adriana's remembered correctly. A ring given by the...
unicorn.
That's right, a ring given by the unicorn. And now then, let's see who's going to come up with an idea. Sergio, what's your idea?
A magic diamond.
A magic diamond. Do we like that one, boys and girls?
Yes.
I think we do. Let's write this one down. So the storybooks that you've had at home this week, what's the title? Because Mrs. Lopith, I can't remember what your title was.
Green Eyes.
That's right.
Mrs. Lopez uses another title from Stage 9 to assess the children's comprehension skills. At the same time, other children in the class carry out a creative writing exercise as an extension of the earlier whole class activities based around the Quest storybook.
Mr. Johnson,
why did you choose Mr. Johnson?
Because he's funny.
Because he's a funny character, is he? What about you, Thaida? Who are you? Who's your favourite character?
The same as Patricia.
And what about Sarah?
Biff.
Patricia, would you like to start off reading then, please?
Nadim's mum and dad had to go away, so Nadim came to stay at Biff's and Chip's house. Nadim had a bag with all his things, but he had a big box too. "What's in that big box?" asked Chip. "Wait and see," said Nadim.
Well done. And well done. You've all been following the page that Patricia's reading. You've read beautifully this afternoon, and you all tried to remember the pointers I asked you, didn't you? We're going to take our books home, and we're going to be practicing our reading till your next session.
The resources used in this lesson were the small storybooks, the teacher's guide, and the comprehension worksheets.